morning, everyone. Welcome to worship from Southwark and Deptford Circuit and our virtual Harvest Festival. Our worship today is based on material from the Arthur Rank Centre, an ecumenical national charity which resources, trains and advocates for rural Christians and the communities they serve. In this most difficult year, the Arthur Rank Centre is encouraging churches to use their Harvest Festival celebrations as an opportunity to thank farmers for all they do for us in supplying the food we need. But let us begin our worship by acknowledging God, who is the Lord of the harvest. Let us pray. Creator God, the whole earth proclaims your glory. Field and the forest, farm and the garden all sing your praise. As we gaze at the world around us, we see your handiwork. Your fingerprint is everywhere. This is your world. Help us to enjoy it gently. In Jesus' name, amen. Now we sing the hymn, "We Plow the Fields and the Scatter."
We plow the fields and scatter the good seed on the land, but it is fed and watered by God's almighty hand. He sends the snow in winter, the waters where the grain, the breezes and the sunshine, and soft, refreshing rain. All good gifts around us are sent from heaven above. Then thank the Lord, oh thank the Lord, for all his love. He only is the maker of all things new and far.
Prayer of praise and thanksgiving. God of life and love, we offer you our thanks and praise in this season of harvest. We thank you that you are creator and provider, the source of all goodness. We thank you for the sunshine and the rain, for the land and the soil. We thank you for the miracle of fertility and growth, for the rhythm of nature and life. We thank you for crops and livestock, farmers and growers. We thank you for our calling to be co-creators with you, and we pray especially for all who share with you in the task of growing and supplying the food we eat. God of life and love, we offer you our thanks and praise. Amen.
Gracious and generous God, we confess our lack of gratitude, our careless attitude towards others, and our wastefulness. We confess our greed and selfishness, our apathy towards those who struggle, and our ignorance and hard-heartedness. We confess our abuse of the environment, our reckless exploitation of the earth's resources, and our lack of respect for creation. Gracious and generous God, we are truly sorry. Forgive us, renew us, and set us free. In the name of Christ, Amen. As the psalmist sings, our God is merciful and gracious, slow to anger, full of unfailing love. We receive God's promised forgiveness. Thanks be to God.
I do hope that you enjoy watching and participating in our online worship services. We've been doing this for over 6 months now, and we appreciate your positive comments, which are always encouraging to the team. But one feedback we've received is that many of you are viewing this as families, and it would be good to have more content that recognises the children and young people who are worshipping with us. So I want to talk to the young people now Adults, the next bit isn't really for you, but I'm sure the kids won't mind you watching. It's that time of year again, where normally schools and churches would be celebrating Harvest Festival. With everything else to prepare, just getting open this autumn, I don't know whether many schools will be doing harvest assemblies this year. And not all of our churches are open to celebrate harvest. So this is our virtual Harvest Festival, and I'm in my kitchen at home, and the fruit and vegetables that I have, I found in our cupboards and in the fridge. I was just talking with my daughter, who's now in her 30s, about her memories of Harvest Festival when she was a child. She tells me that usually the conversation went like this: "Mum, Dad, don't forget, it's Harvest Assembly at school today, and I need to take in some food. Why are you just telling us about this now? It was in a letter I gave you last week." So we would rummage around in the cupboard and we'd come up with something like this: the tin of soup that's been in there for the last 18 months, or a tin of baked beans. I'm sure you're more organised than we were. When Harvest Festival service were invented back in the 19th century, it was all very different. Harvest festivals started in the countryside, and people would bring the produce they'd grown themselves. If you grew cabbages, you would bring a cabbage to church. If you grew carrots, that's what you would bring to Harvest Festival. In the old days, people even brought pigs and other animals to the church. So that got me thinking. If at harvest we brought something that we have made or produced ourselves, what would it be? Not baked beans, that's for sure. Possibly some fruit or vegetables if we've grown them at home, or bread or a cake that we've baked. But for most of us, it would be something different. If you're an artist, it might be a painting or drawing. If you're a writer, it might be something you wrote. What if you're a singer or a dancer? Then a song or a dance could be an offering to God. That's something I'd like you to think about when this service has ended. What is your gift or talent? What do you produce? And how could you offer your very best to God as your harvest offering?
The New Testament reading today is from 2 Corinthians 9, 6 to 15. Generosity encouraged. Remember this: whoever sows sparingly will also reap sparingly, and whoever sows generously will also reap generously. Each of you should give what you have decided in your heart to give, not reluctantly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. And God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. As it is written, they have freely scattered their gifts to the poor, their righteousness endures forever. Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed, and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. You will be enriched in every way, so that you can be generous on every occasion, and through us your generosity will result in thanksgiving to God. This service that you perform is not only supplying the needs of the Lord's people, but is also overflowing in many expressions of thanks to God. Because of the service by which you have proved yourselves, others will praise God for the obedience that accompanies your confession of the gospel of Christ, and for your generosity in sharing with them and with everyone else. And in their prayers for you, their hearts will go out to you because of the surpassing grace God has given you. Thanks be to God for his indescribable gift. This is the word of the Lord.
For the fruits of all creation, thanks be to God. For the gifts of every nation, thanks be to God. For the plowing, sowing, reaping,
Mark chapter 4, verses 26 to 29 from the Good News Translation. Jesus said, "The kingdom of God is like this. A man scatters seed in his field. He sleeps at night, is up and about during the day, and all the while the seeds are sprouting and growing. Yet he does not know how it happens. The soil itself makes the plant grow and bear fruit. First the tender stalk appears, then the head, and finally the head full of grain. When the grain is ripe, the man starts cutting it with his sickle, because harvest time has come." Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditation of our hearts be acceptable in your sight, Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. So let me begin with a confession. I've never been entirely comfortable with the way we celebrate Harvest Festival in our city churches. Most of us are far removed from the countryside and the production of food. We are consumers, not producers. Harvest Festival in rural churches is a real gathering together of the fruits and produce of the land, a community celebration of the end of the harvest. Our harvest offerings are vegetables, tins and packets bought in the shops. And then there are those rousing harvest hymns, "We plough the fields and scatter the good seed on the land." We don't do anything of the sort. I've never ploughed a field in my life, nor have I any inclination to do so. So if Harvest Festival in the city is a bit of an odd celebration, it's even odder when it is a virtual Harvest Festival. I was at Christchurch East Dulwich last week for their harvest, and we had a lovely display on the table, all those different colours and shapes and smells. I'm afraid all I can offer you this morning is the contents of my kitchen cupboard. But you know what? I've come to the conclusion that on the topic of harvest, whatever I think is pretty much irrelevant. Harvest Festival remains a popular feature of church services in the early autumn. We know that those of you who have not yet been able to return to worship in a church building will miss it. And so, hey, as you are watching this virtual harvest service at home, you can join in the harvest hymns with gusto. The service today has been prepared from material produced by the Arthur Rank Centre, an ecumenical organisation that supports mission and service in rural communities. And that includes words that have found their way into this sermon. ARC has a very special theme for Harvest 2020. Thank you to our farmers. This year, many of us will have become aware, perhaps for the first time, of the vital role British farms play in feeding our nation. While the food shortages we experienced in the early days of the COVID-19 lockdown reminded us how fragile the supply chain can be. Unable to go out, many people have been cooking and baking more, and some are growing fruit and vegetables at home for the first time. All of this has resulted in a more conscious appreciation of the food we eat and where it has come from. And as churches and communities celebrate harvest festivals, this is an opportunity to thank the farmers across the UK who grow our food for us. This has been a difficult year for many in the farming community, which is negotiating a triple threat of challenges. The first challenge is the weather. The weather is once again proving to be problematic for many farmers. Last year's autumn and winter flooding meant some crops sown in the autumn were washed away, and the planting of spring crops was delayed. This was followed by a very dry spring, which is having lasting effects. Crops have been slower to grow, and some farmers are already having to feed their animals as there is insufficient grazing available. The second challenge is the present political and economic situation. The shape of new agricultural policy and trade deals is beginning to emerge as Britain renegotiates many of its international relationships post-Brexit. But there will be a significant lack of clarity around the details of this for some time to come. Farmers and the markets they supply don't like uncertainty, whether it is the weather, politics, or economics. And third, well, I don't think you need to guess this one. The COVID-19 pandemic has created significant challenges for the farming community. As we know, the process of harvesting many of our crops is hugely reliant on migrant labour, with people coming to the UK for a season, living and working on local farms before returning home. Much of this travel has been curtailed by restrictions in response to COVID-19. Other farms have sought to increase their income by diversifying into farm shops, holiday lets, and other activities. Again, COVID-19 restrictions have made much of this activity impossible over the last few months. So this year, perhaps more than ever, the farming community in the UK needs our thanks and our support. And there really isn't a better time to do this than Harvest Festival. When we turn to the Bible, we find that creation, land, agriculture and farming are themes which are never far from the surface. Earlier in the service, we watched a video meditation with words from Psalm 65. Living in a land that is relatively dry, on the edge of the desert, the psalmist is acutely aware of the importance of water and praises God for the gift of rain. No rain, no harvest. He sings, "You crown the year with your bounty. Your wagon tracks overflow with richness. The pastures of the wilderness overflow. The hills gird themselves with joy. The meadows clothe themselves with flocks. The valleys deck themselves with grain. They shout and sing together for joy." In the psalm, there is a sense of exuberant celebration as even the hills, valleys, and meadows join the psalmist in a joyful song of praise. Time and time again, this language of the harvest crops up, excuse the pun, in scripture, often in a metaphorical way. In 2 Corinthians, Paul uses the language of sowing and reaping as he encourages the Christians in Corinth to get involved in his pet project, which is a fundraiser for the impoverished church in Jerusalem. I hope I don't upset any church treasurers by pointing out that this scripture wasn't about tithes and offerings in the local church, at least not originally, but what today we would call aid to the world church. Anyhow, Paul uses an agricultural metaphor. Everyone knows that the more seeds you plant, the bigger the results. But ultimately, all this work is God's, as Paul writes in verse 10. "Now he who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food will also supply and increase your store of seed and will enlarge the harvest of your righteousness." In other words, God who gives us our daily bread will also give us the means to be a blessing to others. Think of some of the abundance of nature many of us have experienced in a new way because of COVID-19 lockdown. Birdsong, a profusion of wildflowers, butterflies and insects. The sheer glory of creation is all around us. but God the Creator calls us to work with him. We are workers together with God, writes Paul in 2 Corinthians 6, verse 1. And similarly, in 1 Corinthians 3, 9, we are co-workers in God's service. We see this time and time again in the ministry of Jesus, who so often chose to work with others. A boy whose packed lunch of barley loaves and fish fed a multitude. The woman at the well who witnessed to her Samaritan neighbours and literally brought them to Christ. And at Cana, the servants who had to bring 6 stone jars and fill them, then take the new wine to the steward to taste. These apparently small acts were vital. Jesus performed the miracle, but he chose to work with others. In the same way, farmers work with God in his creation to produce our food. And while not all farmers would use such overtly Christian language, many talk about being stewards of the land, wanting to pass it on in a better condition than they found it. Paul and Jesus chose to depend on the work of others, something we do all the time. For every time we eat, we depend on the farmers who produce our food. Farmers themselves work with many others to grow the food and get it to our tables. We all need to eat, and so we are all dependent on this vast network of people to feed us. But ultimately, of course, we are all dependent on the bounty of a Creator God. As we come to understand that we are working with God's good gifts, our task is imbued with a certain holiness. The things of the earth are important to God, so we should treat them and each other with respect. And that, I guess, is a pretty good reason for celebrating Harvest Festival. So I conclude with a blessing based on those words of Paul. May the Lord of the harvest, the one who supplies seed to the sower and bread for food, supply and increase your store of seed, and so enlarge the harvest of your righteousness. Amen.
In a prayer of intercession, to the bidding, Lord of the harvest, please respond, hear our prayer. Let us pray. Loving God, the countryside is often presented in an unrealistic fashion, a rural ideal of a green and pleasant land, a place of relative affluence to which people can escape for leisure and recreation, where a strong sense of community prevails and life is lived at a gentler pace. We pray for those who live with a reality which is very different. We pray for the 20% of the population in this country living on or below the poverty line. We pray for those who suffer from the lack of appropriate, affordable housing. We pray for farmers expected to produce more food in a more efficient and sustainable way. Lord of the harvest, hear our prayer. Loving God, we give thanks for those who produce our food at land and sea, for farmers, factory and shop workers. We pray for those whom this has been a difficult year, farmers who have battled the weather to grow food, delivery drivers and shop workers who kept working despite the pandemic. Help us to value and support each other. Lord of the harvest, hear our prayer. We pray for issues around the food we buy and eat, for supermarkets and those with power in the food chain, that it may be exercised fairly and justly. We pray for an increased awareness of the ethical choices we make whenever we purchase food. For food production which is sustainable and good for our environment. We pray for policymakers and those with influence, especially with the uncertainties agriculture brought by Brexit, especially for the uncertainties for agriculture that has been brought by Brexit. Lord of the harvest, hear our prayer. We pray for those known to us who are in particular need at this time. We pray for ourselves and for those dear to us. Lord of the harvest, hear our prayer. Loving God, hear our prayers and, with the help of our being and doing, may our prayers be answered through our Saviour, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. As our Saviour taught us, so we pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Good morning. Peace of the Lord be with you.
The peace of the Lord be with you.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
May the peace of the Lord be with you.
May the peace of the Lord be with
you. La paix du Seigneur soit toujours avec vous.
The peace of the Lord be with you. Nyumoye jole ahanye. Amen.
Praise and thanksgiving, Father, we offer for all things living you have made good. Harvest of sown fields, fruits of the orchard, hay from the mown fields, blossom and
Thanks to everyone who has been involved in preparing and producing this week's worship. We close with the blessing. God the Father, who created the world, give you grace to be wise stewards of his creation. God the Son, who redeemed the world, inspire you to go out as laborers into his harvest. God the Holy Spirit, whose breath fills the whole creation, help you to bear his fruits of love, joy, and peace. And the blessing of God, three in one, rest and remain upon you this day and forever. Amen.